In the description of this year's conference, the organizers point to the interpretative role of the arts in society. I would like to go one step further and argue that artists are actively interfering in politics as activists. Through socially engaged art projects, but also in new alliances with social movements, artists not only try to actively influence political debates and realities, but they also contribute to the very design of democracy. While this is also in a way an interpretative role, because thereby they indicate what they see as the central issues of our time, I find it quite important to stress the interventionist character of these practices that cannot be taken for granted in art theoretical terms. In my PhD project, I look at two trends that I and others have observed and that I would like to connect: the growing role of images in politics and the increasingly interventionist character of art practices, activist art. The boundaries of art and politics blur. Citizens and politicians more and more often use creative and artistic concepts and methods as their strategies, and artists and creatives become increasingly activists. If you conceive of this as a directional development, then in the middle, in a field of image and identity politics, where political and art theoretical concepts such as participation and representation overlap in new ways that seem worth studying. This middle where they meet is a new political arena, a new public sphere with new structures, issues, identity concepts, and logics of attention. There is a growing body of research on art activism. By the erosion of artistic autonomy and the Gramscian idea of cultural hegemony as a breeding ground for political ideas are quite central, research on art activism is only rarely being connected with what exactly happens in the political sphere. The trend for metapolitics, especially for research on art activism in Europe, which is what I do, this seems very important. Metapolitics is a term that the new right in Europe uses to describe their own political strategy. It is deeply rooted in the arts. The Italian right-wing organization Color Pound, for example, tries to gain support for their political agenda through cooperation with subcultural actors and strategic image making. Their political strategy is aesthetic and long-term. They take the realm of values and identity to slowly but steadily gain support for their ideas. The same goes for the identitarian movement that is active in many European countries. They use a cultural strategy to normalize their right-wing position. They try to move their extremist positions to the center by using aesthetic means. This happens quite literally, also in spatial terms, for example, on this image where they occupied the Brandenburg Gate in Berlin-Mitte. In many other European countries, the right has used this approach of aesthetic mobilization, which raises many questions on the side of art. In my PhD project, I've picked one European example to understand the dynamic of increasingly activist art on the one hand and increasingly culturalized politics on the other, which is the Brexit debate. Brexit is the exit of the UK from the European Union, which took place on the 31st of January 2020. The most well-known example of artistic engagement in this debate is the anti-Brexit campaign by the German photographer Wolfgang Tillmans. He created a number of posters to be shared and displayed by the public. He used his photography to place textual messages that immediately politicized the reading of the image. For example, here the viewer does not only apply a geographic gaze to this image, but a political one. You see an island, but you don't even know if it is one. So basically, the artist politically instrumentalizes his own artwork and takes away its speculative aspect. Tillmans is using what he calls his language for a political debate outside the art field, bringing in a very interesting symbolic authority. Speaking with Bourdieu, one could say that Tillemans brings in his symbolic capital, as well-known artists have a political say. As a European citizen living in the UK, he had no right to vote in the referendum, so it is a kind of visual vote that substitutes the political one, the convergence of visual and political representation. The architect Wim Koolhaas has coined the term of an iconographic deficit of the EU, matching the democratic deficit. After the Brexit vote, which was decided in favor of Brexit, together with Wolfgang Timmermans, he organized an idea camp in Amsterdam how to better communicate the EU. They invited designers and artists to participate. So basically, the described trend of metapolitics is now also being applied to the EU, which means that the new right in Europe and the EU, which has initially been founded as a backdrop against nationalism, face each other in the very same field of images and cultural politics. They are competitors in the same political economy of attention. In my research, I will look at many more examples of art activism in Europe, trying to understand with what strategies they interfere in politics, but also how these strategies are connected to the culturalizing tendencies in the political field. It is a matching trend, and observing it as such is my current project. Thanks for listening, and we'll get in touch.